So Varsindarpu was telling that Maharaj used to study 14 to 16 hours. And our students complained, Prabhu, 4 hours too much. We cannot match with Maharaj, but at least we should get some inspiration. If you want to achieve something, we have to go through struggle. You cannot get things in an easy way. So in Bengali it is said, kashta korle Krishna mele. Unless we go through trouble, we cannot get Krishna. So any field, not in Krishna consciousness, in order to be successful in our endeavor, we have to go through trouble. So Goswamis took trouble voluntarily, and we should follow in their parampara. Otherwise Krishna will put us in difficulty. Because without difficulty, we cannot get Krishna. Easy way, there is no way. No risk, no gain. No austerity, no trouble. We cannot achieve anything. So it's inspiration for us that Maharaj used to study so long, wholly absorbed in studying Srimad Bhagavatam, and his desire also that devotees of ISKCON should study deeply Srimad Bhagavatam. At least we should spend a few hours, if not 14, 16 hours, at least many hours we should study. 3 hours, 4 hours, whatever is according to our nature, we should study. So just one incident, I am very grateful to Maharaj. I got introduced to Maharaj in Mayapur, because Bhadracharu Prabhu, just like you are from Pune, I think I don't know your love and Bhadracharu Prabhu's love, we cannot compare, but Bhadracharu Prabhu was really inspired by Gaur Krishna Maharaj. And when he used to give katha, Bhadracharu Prabhu will not miss a single word from Gaur Krishna Maharaj. I was very inspired by him, by Bhadracharu Prabhu's absorption in Gaur Krishna Maharaj katha. So Maharaj used to stay in Barsana that time. So I was not so familiar with Vrindavan Dham. So Maharaj told me, please come to Barsana and stay with me. So I took his invitation and stayed with him, and he took me in our me and him, we did Barsana Parikrama first time, and he was explaining all the pastimes of Radharani on Barsana, and also when I was there with him in his place in Barsana. So anything I know about Radharani started with Gaur Krishna Maharaj, and he was very we are a little similar in habits. He likes to be jolly, happy. Devotees means always should be happy and jolly. Should not be so serious. Inside you should be serious. Antare karo nishtha vaire lokachar. That should be devotee. Seriousness should not be shown. I am so serious. You know, I am studying. You should study, but you should be a normal person. So he was like that. He was studying so long hours and speaking hours and hours, but when he is not doing that, very jolly person. So that shows that he has taste. When you don't have taste, you don't feel jolly. You feel burdened. So I don't know how many of you are enjoying studying here. So Maharaj was enjoying the study because he had the taste. So you should pray to Srimad Bhagavatam, we should pray to Maharaj that we should develop that kind of taste in Srimad Bhagavatam. Then our mission will be successful. Studying is not the goal of life. You can study millions of lifetime. Koti janma hari name nai premadhan. You can chant, keep on chanting, but you will not get the taste. In the same way, if you keep on studying, nothing will be revealed. Unless we develop the taste. So sadhana bhakti theke hoy roti rudai, roti garo hoile prem nam koy. Unless our goal is fixed, we cannot achieve our perfection. So in the same way, we are studying Srimad Bhagavatam. What is the purpose? To attain love of Godhead. If that is not achieved, then what is the point of studying Srimad Bhagavatam? But is a sadhana bhakti? So most important part of sadhana bhakti is also studying Srimad Bhagavatam, panchanga bhakti, sadhusanga harinam, bhagavat sravan, mathuravasri murti saddhai sevan. So studying Srimad Bhagavatam is one of the very important aspects of panchanga bhakti, and Maharaj was really spreading that being inspired by his own Guru Maharaj. So this Bhagavata Mahavidyalaya is also trying to establish the principle of Srimad Bhagavatam, and we need his blessings on his holy disappearance day, that we can continue in the same spirit, the way Maharaj used to teach, and the mood, very important, not the way. If mood is missing, everything is missing. We have not come here to become scholar. We have come here to become pure devotee of the Lord, rasik, attachment for Krishna's lotus feet. If that is not there, then you become a dry scholar, arguing on some philosophical aspect of Krishna consciousness. That is not the purpose of studying Srimad Bhagavatam. Muhuruhu rasika bhuvi bhavuka. That is Gaudiya Vaishnava Siddhanta. We have to develop the taste of Srimad Bhagavatam. Then our life will be successful. We can do anyay and not anyay. I should not say secondary, that is not the real goal of life. Why you are entering it deep? Because the mood is to develop taste. If that is the purpose, then everything will be perfect. But if that mood is missing, everything will be missing. So we should focus on that mood, and then our life will become successful. So we pray to His Holiness Gaur Krishna Das Goswami Maharaj to bless us so that we can carry proper mood in spreading the glories of Srimad Bhagavatam. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. His Holiness Gaur Krishna Das Goswami Maharaj ki jai. Gaur Premanandi Hari Hari Bo.